Hi, my name is Ronnie Datta, and today we're going to talk about the Battle of Jalore on Let's Talk About Bharat. In 1311, Delhi Sultanate ruler Alauddin Khilji dispatched an army to capture the Jalore fort in present-day Rajasthan. Jalore was ruled by the Chahamana ruler Kanhad Dev, whose armies had earlier fought several skirmishes with the Delhi forces, especially since Alauddin's conquest of the neighboring Sivana fort. What was the outcome of this battle? Well, to know that, we need to look at the background as well. The kingdom of Jalore was ruled by a branch of the Chahamanas. In 1291, Alauddin's predecessor, Jalaluddin Khilji, invaded Jalore but was forced to retreat after the Vaghelas came to the rescue of the Jalore king, Samanta Simha, who was the father of Kanhad Dev. But in 1299, Alauddin dispatched an army to Gujarat and defeated the Vaghelas. And the 16th century chronicler Firishta claims that Kanhad Dev accepted Alauddin's suzerainty around 1305. But some years later, Kanhad Dev heard Alauddin boasting that no Hindu ruler could challenge him. This rekindled Kanhad Dev's sense of pride and he decided to attack Alauddin, resulting in the invasion of Jalore. This narrative is also repeated by 17th century historian Hajiruddabir. The Delhi forces made several attempts to breach the Jalore fort during the first 7 days of the siege. However, these attacks were foiled by sorties led by Kanhad Dev's brother Mala Dev and his son Virama Dev. On the eighth day, a severe thunderstorm forced the besiegers to retreat, and the Jalore forces launched an eight-pronged attack on one of the retreating detachments at Muklana. The detachment's commander Shams Khan was captured along with his harem, while the rest of his soldiers fled. Next, Alauddin dispatched a stronger army led by Malik Kamal al-Din Gurk, one of his best generals. Kamal al-Din besieged the fort and tried to impose a blockade, most likely intending to starve the defenders. But this strategy was thwarted by timely rains and cooperation from moneylenders who helped replenish the fort's stores. The fall of Jalore is attributed to treachery by a Dahiya Rajput named Bika. After the invaders promised to make Bika the new ruler of Jalore, he led them to an unfrequented and unprotected entrance to the fort. When Bika's wife, Hira Devi, learned about his betrayal, she killed him and reported the matter to Kanhad Dev. However, by this time, the defenders were no longer in a position to achieve victory. Consequently, the men of the fort prepared for a last stand, and Kanhad Dev's son, Virama Dev, was crowned king. The woman decided to die in Chauhan. The Delhi forces breached the fort and thousands of Kanhad Dev's soldiers died in the ensuing fighting. Several of his Samantas or feudal chiefs were also killed in the battle. After breaching the fort, the invaders took 5 days to reach the temple of Kanhaswami inside it. When they threatened to destroy the temple, Kanhad Dev and the last 50 of his surviving soldiers died defending it. His son Virama Dev is said to have died about 3 days after the coronation, thus ending the Chahamana dynasty of Jalore. I hope you liked this video about the Battle of Jalore, and if you did, please share it with your friends and family. Subscribe to MyNation and keep watching. Let's talk about Bharat.